It's the Gong Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, here he is, your host and the star of our show, the sensational Mr. Chuck Berry.
Broke my flower. Thank you. Welcome to the Gong Show. That's an old show business tradition. Means good luck. Now, we've got an unusual selection of relatively unknown amateur and professional talent, all waiting to try to impress our panel of celebrities. The celebrities will rate them, and the act with the highest score will receive this beautiful trophy and this cute little check for $516.32. Thank you. All right. Now, remember, if after 45 seconds one of our celebrities feel the act should stop, not worthy of continuing, he or she will bang that wretched old gong like this. And here comes. Okay. Thank you, Fanny. Now, I want to tell you something. We're very lucky on the show today because we have a very unusual guest to present to Nia to start us off. And I'm thrilled. Sammy Davis Jr.
Mr. Bojangles, come back and dance, 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 please dance. Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, dance. Why can't you come back and dance? Please, Bojangles. Dance. Again, Bojangles.
Not Sammy Davis Jr. That's really Vic Taylor. And we're going to be back to meet our celebrities and find out what they think of Vic right after this message. Hey, that was good. Thank you, and welcome back to Old Gong Land. Now, Vic Taylor was imitating Sammy Davis, and he was using a tape, one of Sammy Davis' cassettes, to do it. Now, remember, our celebrities will be rating our acts on a scale of 0 to 10. Based on the act's entertainment value, creativity, and ability. And now, let's meet our celebrity guests. Today, we bring you a panelist who really believes in fair play. Or as he puts it, gong unto others before they gong unto you. Mr. Bobby Van. Bobby Van. Thank you. Thank you. Bobby.
Okay. Yes.
What do you think of Vic Taylor?
Oh, I enjoyed Vic very much. And I must say, you fooled me. I really thought you were a black man. And you did a terrific job with that makeup. And you were wonderful. I would have given you a much better mark if you were singing it yourself. But Sammy Davis was singing it, so I gave you an 8, Vic.
All right, 8. An 8 for Vic. That's not bad. Now, here's a young lady who not only gongs our acts, but rings my chimes. The lovely Fanny Flagg. Fanny. Fanny, what do you think of old Vic?
I thought you were marvelous. I really did. And I agree with Bobby, and I gave you a 7.
Okay, 7. Not bad. Now, we all know a writer can use pen or pencil to put words in your mouth. But our next guest uses his fingers. Welcome the very funny writer and comedian, a good friend, Pat McCormick.
Thank you.
Pat?
Actually, I was throwing my voice into Vic and also threw some heartburn into him. Vic, you were good. I gave you a 7.
A 7, and that gives you a total of 22 points, and I think that's great. Let's have a nice hand for Vic Taylor. Vic Taylor, very good. All right. All of our acts know beforehand they may be gone, but they don't care. They're just here to have a good time, to be seen on television, coast to coast. All their friends are watching them at the drugstore, and they're really happy. And now let's meet our next act. Our next act consists of 8 entertainers who want the panel to remember that they outnumber you. All right. Here is Corky Carroll and the Funk Dog Surf Band.
That ocean toy, and here's what I said to him. I wanna be a surf freak and drive a surfing van.
That was Quirky Carroll and the old surf funk dog band. Or thereabouts. What a group. I love this group. All right. We're going to go to our celebrities and start with Fanny Flagg. What do you think of Corky Carroll?
I thought they were wonderful. I really did. And I love your outfits, really. And yeah, I love that electric fiddle. Is that what it's called, electric fiddle?
Yeah.
Oh, it's great. And because you are more people than I am, I gave you a 10.
Good deal. All right. Pat McCormick. Pat?
I love him, and I'd like him to do the theme song of my new movie, The Three Stooges Molest a Shut-Innie. I gave him a 9.
A 9, all right. Bobby Mann.
Well, I tell you, this is a really good professional group. These people know what they're doing. Very entertaining. I gave him a 10.
A 10 at 29 points for Corky Carroll and the Funk Dog Surf Band, and they're our new leader. Yeah. Now, we'll be back. Don't go away. Oh, don't go away. We'll be back with more of this stuff right after this message. Part to a performer. In this case, let's try talent. Welcome the wonderful and the hopefully housebroken Taco the Canine Computer.
Taco has baffled medical science with her knowledge in mathematics. Hopefully, she will perform for you today. Taco, what's 2 times 16 divided by 8? Taco, 2 times 16 divided by 8. Come on. 2 times 16 divided by 8. Good girl.
That's my tax account.
5 times 20 divided by 4 minus 22. Give the answer. Taco. 5 times 20 divided by 4 minus 22. Come on. Good girl. Okay, Taco, this is a biggie now. 1,000 minus 994. Give me the answer. Good girl.
That was Taco, and he counted all those things up.
Yes, he did.
He really did. I was still working on the first one. You want to come over here? You sure Taco really did those things?
I'm sure Taco really did those things.
And he went, and it was a score.
Right,
okay.
It is a ventriloquist.
Let's find out what Pat thinks of Taco's counting. Pat McCormick.
Well, any dog that can eat 11 tacos, well, I give him a 7. That's
a 7.
A very good dog.
Okay.
Very good
Bobby
dog.
Bobby Mann, what did you think of Taco the Canine Computer?
I used to love tacos. I gave the actor
a 2. I got that. All right, Sandy Fly.
That little dog, but you know, I don't know how to judge it, so I liked it very much. I gave it an 8.
An 8.
Can I offer some data?
I tell you, I have a suggestion. I give it to my own kids too. Let the dog be a lawyer. Don't let him be in show business. Okay.
Oh no, well that he didn't really mean that. I mean, the dog should be in show business, I think.
All right, let's have a nice hand for old Frida Lip and Taco. I will be back for more of this stuff right after this message. Thank you. I'm just a sucker for dog acts. I got to figure that out. Anyway, now our next act, this is a treat. Now, she's got a smile on her face, a song in her heart, and lint in her navel. I want you to welcome a young bookkeeper, named Deborah. Some good dancing. Now, Deborah, we're going to find out what our celebrities think of your little, what we're doing there. And we'll go to Bobby Mann.
As I was watching her dance, it reminded me how to get my watch fixed. I give her an 8. Okay.
An 8, Deborah, that's pretty good. Let's go to Fanny Fly.
I'm fascinated that she kept that jewel in her navel, and I gave her a 9.
A 9 for a well-held jewel. Pat McCormick.
He's, was... mixing a milkshake for me, which she's going to meet in my room later. I gave her a 9.
A 9. All right. 26 points. And I think that's real good, Deborah. For a bookkeeper, your office must be a lot of fun. I want to thank you for being on the show. Let's have a nice hand for old Deborah. There you go, Deb. Okay. We got another one. Let's face it. If you don't have talent, there's no way you can get on television. Luckily for us, our next act found the Gong Show. Now, here is the greatest imposter in show business, Kid Hopi Chopi the Corn Popper.
Folks, you'll never believe this, but today I run into, on the way to the studio, none other than and Mama Tums. Mother Tums to you. And she stopped me, she asked me, she says, are you an entertainer? Are you an actor, she says. I says, why do you ask? She says, because you look like an actor. I says, what else is new? She says, come on, quit kidding. She She says, "Are you or are you not an actor?" And I replied, I says, "If I was an actor, I wouldn't know how to act." And I told Mama Tum, I said, "Mama Tum, I'm going to sing you a song. I'm gonna celebrate America's tricentennial. I'm gonna sing the tricentennial of America."
Did it
Oh no, Corn Popper. It was just that I don't know. Let's find out why. I thought you were just cooking. Let's find out. Bobby Van, why did you do that to old Corn
When he
Popper?
First came out here, I thought he was going to do Sammy Davis Jr. He got me a little confused there.
Do you know that he was the lookout at Pearl Harbor?
Listen, Corn Popper, I think you were great. I want to tell you, it's better than being caught loitering on the street. And I think it's nice having you on the show. And you have a present.
Thank you very kindly.
Really appreciate having you.
Thank everybody here.
Let us have a nice hand for Corn Popper. Corn Popper. There it goes, Corn Popper. Find out who our winner is today in the Gong Show right after this message. Thank you. All right. It's time to announce the winner in the good old Gong Show today. It's been one of those days, all right? And it's 29 points is the winner, the Funk Dog Surf Band. Yeah. Trophy and Porky, I want to give you this check for $516.32. I want to thank you all. You were really great. Really. Thank you, Milton Lutz, Pat McCormick, Manny Flagg, and Bobby Van. This is me.